And welcome to makeup demo number 7. Once again, I'm starting with foundation. My face has been washed and cleaned and moisturized. I'm using a damp makeup sponge and Revlon age-defying makeup. And I'm blending it along the hairline and the jawline and the chin. And that again is the key to foundation. You want to blend it very carefully and very thoroughly. After foundation, I'm going to apply concealer and an eyeshadow base, and we'll get to that very shortly. Here I'm showing you a product by Max Factor, which is no longer sold in America. This is several years old, but it's still good. And it's called Erase Color Precise. It's a concealer. And I'm using it under the eyes to kind of conceal under eye circles. If you have short enough nails, you can use your fingers. Otherwise, you can use a concealer brush or a sponge tip applicator. Professional makeup artists, years ago when I used to work on shows, would use their fingers to apply something like this, but they might also use a sponge. And today, a lot of makeup artists will prefer brushes to sponges, so it's a matter of your personal preference. Here, my nails are short enough to not interfere with the eye area. When they are longer, I would need a sponge or a brush to blend it in. I will then apply an eyeshadow foundation. Product by Too Faced, as you can see, that's coming up, and I will then set it with translucent dusting powder. Some of this I've demonstrated before. This is a repeat for this particular product by Too Faced, and this will help the eyeshadow to last longer and it intensifies the colors. I will then set it with translucent dusting powder. Defining my eyebrows very lightly, gentle, quick strokes, using a Ben Nye eye pencil. This can work for eyebrows as well as eyeliner, and it's very inexpensive. And as I've said before, you don't always have to spend a lot of money on cosmetics. What matters is whether or not you like the product and does it perform to your satisfaction. A more expensive product does not always perform better. Sometimes it does, but sometimes you're just wasting money. I buy these products sometimes at Cinema Secrets and at certain other makeup stores. Ben Nye, this eye pencil is maybe $2, perhaps $3 at the most. It was not expensive. And as I've said before, I try to get things on sale. If there's half off or a clearance, and you can afford to, buy one extra and save yourself some money. Starting on the outer edges of the eyes, working toward the middle where the pupil is, gradually tapering the line in. I don't like heavy eyeliner, speaking for myself. That's a personal preference. Everyone is different, but this is my particular style when it comes to eyeliner. I'm now going to apply a product that is possibly no longer carried by Maybelline. This is several years old, possibly from 2007 or 2008, maybe 2008. It's called Dream Mousse Shadow, and it's shade number 30, Mint Cream, by Maybelline. And I'm using a sponge tip applicator. I will apply this over the entire eyelid, basically, from the eyelid to the brow line. And then I'm going to enhance the color by taking another eyeshadow by Maybelline, a darker green. And this is an example of a monochromatic eyeshadow effect where you're using basically two similar colors from the same family. In this case, green, a very light green, and then a darker green. It can be very pretty. And a cream shadow base, and then a powder eyeshadow over it. So the two colors actually work in conjunction very nicely together, as you'll see. And with the two-faced eyeshadow base, it intensifies the colors and helps them to last longer throughout the day. So this works very nicely if you want to layer color and don't want to use, let's say, a single light shade, like the color I'm currently using here. If you want to add depth, you can go one shade darker with a powder shadow. I like the effect this has. Now I'm about to apply the second layer of eyeshadow, also by Maybelline, and the color is called Antique Jade. It's a pearlescent eyeshadow, a very pretty shade of green. And these Maybelline products are not expensive. They're pretty, they're very nice, they apply nicely. I had a little problem with the Dream Mousse Shadow. It's a bit crumbly, but at the same time, like I said, it's several years old. I think it was always a little bit on the dry side. It doesn't apply very easily or very evenly. That's a personal critique of the product. Perhaps in the future I'll try something by Shiseido to give you a comparison. There are times when you do get a better product by spending more. Sometimes yes, sometimes no. I've been by and large happy with my Maybelline eyeshadows. The pearlescent green that I'm currently applying here is very nice, and I like it in conjunction with the cream green eyeshadow base. They work well together. Now I'm applying my favorite mascara, which is by Lancôme, called Finesseals. The other mascara I like very much is by L'Oreal. Both mascaras are actually made by the same parent company. One is just the expensive department store version, the other is the less expensive drugstore version, but both work extremely well. And you'll see me applying upper and lower lashes, and on the upper lashes, both sides of the lashes, which is a little technique I learned many years ago when I was working on a modeling portfolio, and I noticed the makeup artists I dealt with covered both sides of the lashes. It's just a preference I have. And if you get any extra mascara on your upper lids, you can always use a sponge tip applicator, which you'll see me do, to remove a little bit of a black dot here or there. So sometimes mascara crumbles a little, or you get a little excess someplace, you can quickly remove it. It's not a big deal. cheek blush. It is by Milani, called Sunset Duos. And basically it's a blush and a bronzer combined. And the shade is number 03, Sunset Beach. And basically I dipped the brush into both colors. There's a rosy pink and a soft brown, kind of a nude shade. And I make certain that the brush picks up both colors and I blend them in. And I tend to put on a little more cheek blush than I actually intend to keep. It's just something I do because I plan on removing the excess with tissue. So whatever is too much, I just remove it with tissue. And in the course of removing it with tissue, I'm also blending it at the same time, which is again the key to makeup is blending, particularly blending foundation and blending cheek blush. And now I'm going to apply a base for my lipstick, which is something I generally do 98% of the time. I put a foundation of some kind on my lips to help the color last longer and keep it from feathering and bleeding. And this is a product called Lip Lock. And I will set it again with powder and then apply lip liner, which is going to be shade number 42, Brick by CC. Again, not expensive. These are not expensive products. A CC lip liner is about $4 now. Again, not expensive. I'm applying a lip liner at a 45 degree angle, basically, and I'm not using the very tip of the pencil. I'm using a side of the pencil, the tip and the side basically combined to get the edge I'm getting. Because I'm trying to kind of blend the lip liner into the lip. I don't want a hard edge. And I'm going to blend the lipstick into the lip liner. So basically, I'm trying to create an effect where you don't know where one begins and the other ends. It's not going to be a very hard edge by the time this is done, as you can see. The lipstick I'm using is one I've kind of created. It's basically Revlon Copper Glaze Brown, shade number 04. Also known as number 335. It has been discontinued, unfortunately, but I bought this color several years ago. Again, if you love a color, ladies, buy more than one, because what'll happen is your favorite lipstick will be discontinued, and you will be very upset, as I have been, because it's a color that I've used for years. And in this case, I've created a kind of pot gloss effect with it, where I've taken half the lipstick tube and I blended it with a certain lip gloss by Meron, and then I can just dip my lipstick brush into it. It just saves time. It does change the effect of the lipstick a little bit, but that's okay. And in a future demo, I may show you how I do that when you want to create your own colors or create a lipstick method that's fast and quick in the morning when you're in a hurry. And that wraps it. Thank you for watching and for giving me your time. I hope you found it helpful. Thank you.